Very good afternoon to all respected jury members, respected Dr. Ranjit Singh sir, and all my senior and fellow presenters. So my topic for today is crime scene reconstruction and preservation. So first of all, let's get to know that what is reconstruction and why is it being done? So crime scene reconstruction is basically a process of determining or eliminating the events that have occurred in a crime through the analysis of the crime scene, location of the physical evidences, and further lab examination of those evidences. So the next slide, please. Thank you so much. So in a crime scene, what is regularly done is a crime has occurred in a scene. So the police officers, the first investigating officers are reaching over there, they're approaching the scene, they're securing the scene. As we often see that, in almost every crime scenes, nobody is allowed to enter. It is being sealed from all the sites. Later on, the identification is done. Further documentation of the scene is done. Sketching of the scene is there. Then photography of the scene is being done. Photography consists of close range photographies, reference frame photographies and all. And videography is practiced these days as we get to hear that on 16th of October 2018, the Supreme Court of India has taken a giant leap in the investigation mandatizing the videography in 6 cities of India for crime investigations, namely Delhi, Mumbai, Chandigarh, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, and Bangalore. So the next slide, please. Thank you, sir. So, I'll come up to my proposed methodology and the topic from my topic. But first of all, I would like to give reference of 2 of these cases. Briefing the scene in short, we can see the first image is of a double murder case of Noida of 2008, popularly known as Arushi Talwar murder case. This is one of the most cited cases if we go by the trials by media. So, what happened in this double murder case, Arushi Talwar murder, the double homicide of Arushi Talwar, a 13-year-old girl and a 45-year-old domestic help, Mr. Hemraj. So in this incident, the case occurred on 15th of May 2008. Later on, by the autopsy findings, it was discovered that the murder was committed during 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. in 16th of May, 2008. So in the initial investigation, it was suggested that Hemraj, the domestic help, was the primary suspect. But on the next day, Hemraj's decomposed body was found on the terrace of the same apartment. Later on, the police were criticized for not securing the crime scene properly. And soon a lot of media theories came up. We are not going to deal with that. Then comes the first CBI investigation. They claimed that there were 2 more assistants of the parent of Arushi Talwar who were considered to be the prime suspects. But the CBI investigation, they also criticized the police for not securing the crime scene properly and blamed the media people for rushing into the crime scene, which had potentially damaged and destroyed and altered a lot of physical evidences, even biological evidences and all. So later on, when the next CBI investigation was set up on 2009, it was suggested that the culprits were the parents of Arushi Talwar, Dr. Rajesh Talwar and Dr. Nupur Talwar. But later on, in 12th of October 2017, both of them were set free due to lack of evidence. Now, for my topic over here, in this case, there was a person, the ex-DSP of Noida, Mr. K.K. Gautam, who went up to that crime scene. He examined a few locations and later on he has given a statement to the CBI. Then the emergence of the sudden discovery of Hemraj's body a day later, which was already being complained by the residents nearby that they have been sighting dragging marks of blood towards the terrace. And Mr. K.K. Gautam also given a statement that he has found 3 glasses of liquor in Hemraj's room. Among them, 2 of the glasses had liquor and another one was partially empty. So the next slide, please. Thank you so much, sir. So over here, what we see, the existing methodology for capturing these crime scenes and preserving them, they are photography, further on to a videography thing. But in my proposed theory, photography done by 2 forensic photographers may be different because of their individual perspective. So what I have been working on and proposing a method of using a catadioptric lens, compiling it in a setup of 8 camera lenses covering a 360 view in each plane. Over here, we can see on the right-hand side, that's the ski structure of the placement of the cameras. And below that is a 360 image. So the next slide, please. Thank you. So in the proposed methodology, using this omnidirectional camera with catadioptric lenses and 8 of them covering the entire area, this can be presented in 2 different expressions. That is VR presentation or AR presentation. In VR presentation, the virtual reality, recent days we have got softwares like V360, FCP Pro X, Mocha VR and all. So we can give it VR structure. And this, what it will do, that the first investigating officer, when is arriving in the crime scene, they can capture the crime scene with an omnidirectional camera instead of doing a simple videography. What this will benefit, the further next or the last investigating officer can get the exact similar view that of the first investigating officer. So in my first case that I discussed of Arushi Talwar, due to the coming of media people, relatives and other people in the house and cleaning of the house later on, have destroyed a lot of evidences as claimed by the CBI. Almost 90% of the physical evidences were lost or destroyed. But if the scene was captured through an omnidirectional camera, then at least the positional accuracy could have been preserved. We could have later on found out that the statement of the ex-DSP of Noida, Mr. K.K. Gautam, who on later in the court of law, who denied to his own statement, complaining that his statement was altered, tampered and modified in the court of law. So if it was recorded and captured with an omnidirectional camera, we could have seen the 3 glasses and all the physical evidences, the dragging marks of blood towards the terrace, the blood mark on the lock of the terrace and everything, which would have increased the positional accuracy of the evidences and may have been able to change the verdict, as it wouldn't have been a case of lack of evidences. So thank you.